Hey, Shrek. Man, I am traipsing through mud right now. I'm in a mess right now. I'm in what they call, I'm in a quandary. And where am I going right now? Where are we going today? Well, we are shooting off across the mesa towards Baby Canyon. And this time, we're driving in. So we drove to the lines, and now we're going to try to work our way over to Baby Canyon and see what we can find. We're trying to find, actually, Baby Canyon 2, which is on down the road, which it's going to be interesting, but this hike is terrible. But we're so close, we just had to come see it. I mean, there's no other way to explain it. I've got my radio, and I've got a little cow path. It's kind of getting a little bit of, making things a little easier, but I'm excited today what the adventure today is. So we're gonna trek on over, hopefully be over there pretty quick. I mean, shouldn't take long. And look where I'm headed. Right there, we're just trucking across here. These rocks are just horrendous. But we're gonna take another entrance in, see how close we come. I'm pretty damn good at shooting guesstimates. And we'll see what we find. So we're gonna get on this trail and get on this journey today, and hopefully it'll be a quick run across. Gonna look back the truck and our journey, and see what we run into. Now, one thing I did was I decided that I wasn't going to use the backpack today, and I was going to slim down. Now, what I'm seeing is, this is not easy hiking across this. You know, you can see why they love this area, because, it didn't rain for a long time. And I'm traipsing through mud up here. So, and then with the grasslands, you can't see this volcanic material.
That's all beans and mills, come in.
And, this is Cecil.
Just checking on you. I can see you, but you're getting out there now.
Well, I'm trying to put a turbo boost on it and make a move quick. It will be extremely curious to see how long it actually takes me, since you're timing me basically to get over there. I'll really be curious. Well, right in front of me looks like it was the cliff face that we walk, if you're seeing me. And then this area right here is I'm heading right towards where we came out at.
Okay, great.
Well, here we are. We're at Baby Canyon, looking around, coming in at a different angle. And there's supposed to be petroglyphs all on these cliff walls right in here. And, I'm trying to think of the first time or the last time I was here, did I miss them? And I'm trying to see right now what condition they're in. And I'm not seeing what I thought I would be seeing. Thought I'd see all kinds of stuff. And so here is a lot of the petroglyphs that they're talking about what they saw. But a lot of these, they're extremely difficult to really see what you're getting a hold of. And they're not, I don't want to put anybody's rock art down, but the rocks they chose is not conducive to good petroglyphs that seeming to stay. I always like to try to find me a shaman cave when I'm on these journeys. You know, I see stuff, but it's just maybe not as much of what I was looking for in my own head, and what kind of glyphs I was looking for. We are here today to see what I call Baby Canyon 2, which is really Baby Ruin 2, I should say. I should be clearer on that. And then we'll say Baby 3 for another journey, which is on the other side. But this whole area was inhabited by a large number of natives. So let's talk about the Perry Mesa tradition. Now, I'm going to tell you what I believe. I believe this was a community that in the 13s to the 1400s had a population boom, and a lot of different cultures from a lot of different areas came to this location, the Perry Mesa and the Black Mesa, and they cohabitated. And I think they got along, but I think there was outside forces that coming in that actually changed their world. Now, why would I say that? Because there's so many different forms and cultures of petroglyphs that definitely makes this unique in the area of petroglyphs that I've come across. So it's almost like four or five different cultures that are drawing stuff, pecking stuff. It's a nice rock that's been... So when I first came here, I saw these rocks, and it wasn't like I thought they were the greatest rocks ever. Now, the ancients may have thought differently. Now, Baby Canyon, why is it called that? They found a grave of a baby that was buried with a bird, which was not totally uncommon at that time. And that's where the name of Baby Canyon come from. So, you know, they have researched this, and they have done every one of these rocks. And so along all these are petroglyphs, but they don't stand out like a lot of areas that we go to. You know, they're not as prevalent. It's not definitely an easy hike over here, but see some over here. Now, I've got the paper, and this stuff was everywhere. So there were petroglyphs all over this area. And let me get down here and see what's over here. But on this rock, they're just not nearly as prevalent as other locations here. So if you look over here, you're right there, okay? It's kind of a dog man, which I actually really like that dog man. But, you know, they're just not the rock that they had to work with, just wasn't as conducive to petroglyphs that stayed right there. They spent a lot of time surveying this area. And the only reason that I'm a little confused is some nice little dots, is they're not as impressive as so many other locations here. And so I'm a little baffled by it. And see if we can spot it. What a beautiful place. Imagine that place with the wall all the way around. Imagine that place with, you know, look at this. All the way through here, everywhere you go. Nice black. Here's this. It's nice stone. Stuff is all over. So you're not gonna run out of things and places You know, as I walk around this this mesa today, in areas where there are ruins, I have to go back to the fact that, you know, there were people all over. You didn't go anywhere on this mesa without bumping into somebody. You know, and you wasn't by yourself anywhere up here. There were that many people. And so when I crossed these places, you know, a lot of this tundra, you know, it would have been worn down. And it's just amazing to walk through here and realizing that regardless wherever you turned, you know, there was somebody. Well, I've been traipsing through here, and the crazy thing is I can see the truck. I don't know if I wanted to see that truck. I didn't want to realize that I had got that far, but you know, you're almost there. It's like, damn it. Kind of like what they say about swinging halfway across the English Channel. Got tired and turned around. Well, that didn't make any sense. You're almost here. I think those are rock walls. I actually surely hope they're rock walls, but I don't know. Come on, be walls. Yes, I would say that is walls. So we have officially got Baby Canyon 2 in the record books. And I am pretty excited about what we're about to see. There's some nice pets right there. Little dugout area. You know, a little abode in here. There's Baby Canyon down there on the edge. You know, the walls aren't nearly as pristine as I was hoping they would be. Had a lot of high hopes for this. And had a lot of high hopes for stuff here. And, you know, it just, you never know what you're going to get. You know, never know what you're going to find. We're going to look around a little bit before we head back. Pot shards everywhere. It's a good, you know, it's a standard Agua Fria. I don't know about that. It's a standard Agua Fria location. You know, one thing nice is I don't see a lot of stacks of pottery. Like people are, you know, look at this, you know. It's nice. Leave it where it is. A little can in the middle. Probably somebody that was up here pot hunting. Now, I didn't see that. Okay, now I just got excited. I just got excited. I wasn't as excited, but now I was looking off this cliff, and man, I am just walking through thousands and thousands of pieces of shards. They're absolutely everywhere. And I got out on this point, and there are some cool structures out here. And they look like there's some glyphs up on that big rock right there. But what I got my attention was that rock wall out there. Now we're talking about, look at that circle. Well, I'm going to have to walk this ridge. I'm going to have to do it. I mean, I'm here and I'm going to have to take a look. But this is what you get here. This is what you get in the Agua Fria. I would not be surprised regardless of what I actually found here. I would not even be surprised at all. What's down here? I would not even be surprised at this level of what's here. Look at these pieces. This is a fabulous location. Now, we did see some trash from some people that came here before, which sucks, to be honest with you. But You just want to see if there's something down here, because you just never know. Look at that piece right there. They were doing something down here. Look at there. That's a beautiful piece. Look at that thing right there. I don't even know what that is, but look at there. That is got something. Like, it looks like $11.99. It's funny when you see those and you think, wow, this is, you know, I just got taken to another level, okay? We just got taken to another level. I went across there and I was like, wow, that was a little hairier than I thought, but I didn't actually go across there. I was up here on this level, so, which is better. But look at the amount of stuff that's over here. This is an incredible place by far. Very special place. I'm not even... Boy, it looks like something. Wow. Oh, Jesus criminy. Oh my God. I tell you what, I have stumbled around. I'm gonna make a 30-minute call that I get out of here by 30 minutes down. How crazy and cool is that? I'll tell you what. Right here, look at that stone. Beautiful. Look at that. That is gorgeous. Look at that. It's the pot hunters that robbed the place. I'm a little overwhelmed. This is pretty crazy. This is pretty crazy. This wall here, a little bit of a wall left down there. Look across here. All those rocks used to be up on this wall. I'll tell you what, you know, you don't get, when you do this, you don't get awe-inspired very often, but I'm telling you what, this place is unbelievable. Man, I'm overwhelmed right now. I'm overwhelmed. Some of these places, you just feel them. You don't in every one of them, but man, sometimes you feel their presence here. It is absolutely unreal. And you know what? Keep this stuff, take care of it, man. There's a beer bottle or something down there and you're like, damn it, man, just, you know, come enjoy it. Look at it, protect it. Man, make sure that the next generation gets to see this, because I'm a little overwhelmed with this. I'm a little overwhelmed. Look at that wall. Those are beautiful. Those walls are beautiful. But you know that, man, if they just left them alone, they'd have stayed up too. They start digging them, and then that starts the collapse of the wall. And, wow, but look at that work. It's even got a little bit of a rounded corner in it. That's pretty awesome. You know, somebody took a lot of pride in that, man. Somebody was up here and they took pride in building that. Look at that. Now that sucks. Look at that. You know, I want to throw it over the cliff, but you know what? That's not what you do, but I want to. Don't dig this, man. Pretty nice wall down there. This is right here. Look at that. Look at that. Well, it's laying there. Well, man, I hope you liked our trip to Baby Canyon too. How awe-inspiring that was. And you know, the great news about Baby Canyon is too, is I've got to come back because I lost my walkie-talkie somewhere. So, you know, that absolutely sucks, but if you find it, let me know. So what that means is, looks like I get to adventure back out to Baby Canyon to experience Find Jeff walkie-talkie. You know, I had a microphone I lost out here, and I just got extremely lucky. It's one of the reasons that you see this blue strap is that, you know, it's another stop to maybe not lose stuff because you're climbing around this stuff. But man, I'll tell you what, tough day today, great day today, awesome day today. It was worth whatever I got to pay for a walkie-talkie today. So whatever that is, I'll just have to pay it. But was it worth it? Absolutely it was worth it. I'm glad you guys got to come along with us today. So I'm going to head it on down the trail. I'm starting to cramp up a little bit. So I'm going to make my way back to the truck and get ready to ride an hour and a half to get back to the highway and get out of Agua Fria for today. So got a reason to come back now, don't I? Definitely got a reason to come back. Not that you need a hell of a lot of reason to come back, but I definitely got one. So, man, I hope you enjoyed this. If you did, please like and subscribe. You know, if you'd like to donate to Patreon for maybe extra walkie-talkies, feel free to. Gasoline, if not, just like and subscribe. And if you hit that notification bell, then guess what? Every time I post, you can come along on the adventure, and we can share this experience with each other, and had a great time. I will see you, and you'll be safe, and get outside, because that's what we need to do. Get outside.